Hi, my name is Tommy. Welcome to the Semaphore channel. How are you doing? Today, I want to talk about CI/CD. Continuous Integration and Delivery, or CI/CD, is a set of practices for developing and shipping software. In this video, I'm going to talk about all these practices and how you can implement them into your team and workflows. But first, let's figure out why we should care about CI/CD. Less risk, because we have a safety net of tests that will catch errors before they reach production. More velocity. We can move faster because we have a feedback loop that tells us when things go wrong or go right. More experimentation. We can focus on experimentation. We can even test, do A/B experiments to figure out which features work best for the user. Better productivity. The whole system is designed to give a satisfying experience, taking away chores from developers, letting them do interesting work. More happiness. A good CI/CD will make developers more productive, faster, and overall happier. Too good to be true? Let me explain. What is CI/CD? Continuous Integration and Delivery is a method for developing software. It's part of DevOps, which is usually presented with the infinity symbol. We start with a plan, we code a prototype, then we build and test it. When it's ready, we create a release package that is deployed. Once it's working, we operate and monitor the application, and the cycle starts over. Each new cycle is informed by what we learned in the previous one, and this is the key point of the DevOps infinity symbol, that we are continuously improving, each cycle producing a better version of our software. So, this is DevOps. How does CI/CD fit in? CI/CD stands for Continuous Integration and Continuous Delivery. The job of Continuous Integration is to produce an artifact that can be deployed. In this context, an artifact can range from anything like a zip package, a jar file, a compiled binary, or a full Docker image that you can run in a Kubernetes cluster. If you can deploy it or run it, it's an artifact. Now, to verify that the artifact works as expected, we use automated tests. In that way, continuous integration covers the build and test portions of the site. For CI to work, we need two things. First, developers merge their changes into the main branch daily. Second, each merge triggers an automated build and test sequence. The result of this process is either a success or a failure. The failure can be on the build step or any of the tests. In either case, the process stops here until the errors are fixed. If the CI process succeeds, we can move into continuous delivery. The goal of continuous delivery is to create a release we can share with our users. We can go even one step further and deploy the release into production. This process is sometimes called continuous deployment. As with CI, the delivery and deployment step is automated. So for example, we may have a process that packages the application and releases it to GitHub, or creates a Docker image that pushes it to a Docker registry. And if we are deploying, the process can take the image and put it into a server or a Kubernetes cluster. So at this point, you might be screaming into the monitor saying, "I know, I am already doing CI/CD. Why are you telling me this?" Now, don't get me wrong. I know you have good automation, you have good tests. But are you sure your system is continuous? Can any developer in your team release or ship the current version as it is in less than 20 minutes without worrying about breaking something? If the answer is yes, congratulations, you can stop viewing the video now. But if the answer is no, you are not really doing CI/CD because the continuous part is missing. Okay, since you're still with me, I'm going to assume you're interested in doing CI/CD. So let's see how to implement that. First, we need a CI pipeline. This will build and test the application. The key thing is that the process should be thorough. It must test the application sufficiently, so we are comfortable with the release if the test passed. And the process must be fast. It should take less than 10 minutes. So in this example, we have a build step that builds the compiled application, some unit tests, integration tests, and security audits, and finally end-to-end test. So if the test suite is thorough, we can safely assume that the application is correct for deployment. The second part is the delivery. Here we build a package that can be released or deployed or shared. This is a stage that goes after CI once the process has passed. And in CD, we automate all the packaging step. In this case, we are building a Docker image and pushing it into a Docker registry. We can also automate the deployment. So in this case, we take the application and push it into a Kubernetes cluster, and then we run smoke test to see if the deployment went correctly. We can also dial up the complexity. In this case, we are taking the same idea. The CI pipeline builds a Docker image and pushes it into the registry after testing. And we are doing here a canary deployment where we deploy part of the application to a portion of the user, so maybe 5% of the users. And we use a Kubernetes cluster for this. We select which users are going to receive the update, deploy the application, and do all the test and migration steps of the database. Once everything's working correctly and we are comfortable with the release, we can have a third deployment. Let me scroll a little bit up here. In this case, we are deploying into production the whole application for the whole user base, and we can have a fourth phase here, which does the rollback. So in case the canary didn't went well, we can roll back to the previous version without an outage, and all the process is automated. And we can use a system like this to do A/B testing and test features for different user groups. So this graphic nicely sums up all the process. We have a build stage, test stage, and this creates the artifact to be deployed, and then we can evaluate if this is a release or not. We can, for example, check what branch we are dealing with. Is it main or master? Are we using a git tag? If the artifact is not to be released into production, we can release it into a staging environment where we can run tests in a more real scenario. And then if everything goes okay, we can merge those changes back and start the process again. If we are on the master branch, if we are going to release, we enter the continuous deployment stage where we deploy the application, run our test, and then the system is live. Getting into the rhythm of CI/CD takes some time. There is certainly an investment to set up all the processes and let everyone find their way around them. But hopefully at the end of all this effort, we reach a state in which we can push code to a repository and let CI/CD take over. So what is the best possible scenario? What is the best a CI/CD pipeline can look like? First, your CI/CD is lightning fast. It provides quick feedback. You use parallelization, you use faster machines, you have optimized slow tests and detected flaky tests. You are continuously improving on your pipeline, so it's very fast and you have a feedback loop that's very short. Next, you should be able to deploy main or master at any time, any day of the week without stressing. You can hide incomplete features using feature flags and shape the code as it is. You should have a test suite that you can trust, meaning that if the test passed, you should be pretty much confident that the application will work. You must work on your test suite and improve it continuously. And finally, you do trunk-based development, which means you don't have long lead branches. You are merging your branches daily into master. You are working in small steps and iterating over and over. This means there is no merge hell to deal with. The final result is that after all this effort, your team will start releasing monthly, then weekly, then daily. You can be agile in the original sense of the term and deliver value incrementally. Now, are there cases in which CI/CD is not possible? Yes, but only in limited spaces. For example, banking, aerospace, and medical industries, there may be regulations that prevent something like CI/CD from ever being implemented. But for the rest of us, CI/CD is always possible. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, why don't you leave a like and subscribe? Are you doing CI? Leave me a comment. I really appreciate your feedback. I read and respond every comment. Thank you for watching and see you on the next one.